各位同学，大家好，又和 Coco 老师见面了。今天我们要学习主要绘画的是长方形，画神奇的云朵中的房子。Hello everyone, good to see you again. Today we're going to draw the magic cloud and the building. 我们先画一个长方形。Let's draw a rectangle first. 但不用画出最底下的一条线。But no need to draw its bottom line. 紧挨着画第二个长方形。Very close to it, we draw the second rectangle. 这个长方形画高一点。We draw this one a little bit taller than the first rectangle. 仍然先不用画出最底下的那条线。Still, we don't need to draw the bottom line here. 使用同样的方法。Using the same way.我们画出第三个长方形。We draw the third rectangle. This is the shortest one. 现在给每个房子添上三角形的房顶。Now we draw the rectangle roof for every building. 有些房顶高，有些房顶矮。Some roofs are tall, some are short.同学们可以用不同的图案来装饰你画的房顶。You can use different pattern to decorate the roof. 这里我使用斜线来装饰这个房顶。Here I use diagonal line to decorate this one. 其他两个我先不画，留给你们去做装饰。I left those two for you to decorate. 现在我们来画这片神奇的云。Now, let's draw the magic cloud. 我们先在画面的底端画一条长长的直线。We draw a long straight line at the bottom of the picture first. 这条直线最好画的比三个大楼的宽度还要长。This line better be drawn longer than the width of the three buildings together. 现在用弧线画出云朵。We draw the cloud top by using curved line.画上正方形的窗户 ，a square window here。长方形的三个窗户 ，three rectangle windows。圆形的窗户 ，a circle window。给这片神奇的云画上漂亮的眼睛吧。Let's draw eyes for this magic cloud. 它是一朵微笑的云 ，a lovely smile face. 现在我来装饰这两个房顶。Now, I'm going to decorate these two triangle roofs. 你画的和我一样吗 ？Did you draw the same as me? 瞧。数字也能起到很好的装饰作用呢。Look, do you think using numbers here is also a good idea? 我们涂色啦 ，That's coloring。小朋友们，你们学会了吗？希望你们订阅和点击 Coco 老师的频道，给我点赞，跟我一起学习绘画。我们下次再见。